Customizable controls allow players to dial in their experience to be close to exactly what each of them individually wants and have been configurable on PCs for a very long time. But by comparison, this is a relatively new concept to controllers, and Microsoft has been killing it with the Xbox One Elite Wireless Controller Series, bringing rear paddles and custom controller profiles to a first-party peripheral so console gamers can dial in their experience and take their game to the next level. Welcome back to the Rogue Gentleman Gamer channel. My name is Josh, and today we're taking a look at the Series 2 Elite Controller from Microsoft. For those that don't know, I stream every Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and every other Wednesday, and you guys can find the link for that down below. I got excited last year when Microsoft announced that they would be improving upon the already awesome Xbox Elite Wireless Controller. The original Elite Controller clocked in at $150 in the US upon its debut in 2015, costing about twice as much as a standard Xbox Wireless Controller. Now, this caused some gamers to choke at the price, but this was in the same ballpark as most other custom controllers designed for competitive gamers. Being a fan of the original Xbox S variant controller, the 360 controller, and the standard Xbox One controller, my curiosity was naturally piqued by the customization options this would offer, but the price point did seem a little bit steep, and I wasn't into custom controllers at the time when they originally released, as I wasn't playing many competitive first-person shooter games, so I dismissed the original Elite Controller as a cool idea, but a novelty I wasn't willing to pay for at the time. However, in 2016, after I started streaming regularly and playing more online FPS games, the Elite Controller again got my attention as something potentially worth an investment, and I picked one up later in 2016. Now, I don't remember the specific date, as I really never did an unboxing for it at that point, and can't remember exactly what game I started using it in, whether it was Black Ops 3 or Titanfall 2. I do remember using it early in the life of Titanfall 2, but not immediately, and instantly falling in love with the controller. I felt like I was able to more efficiently utilize Titanfall 2's movement mechanics, and setting the aiming curve helped me tweak the control stick response so I was able to get to targets faster and just in general improve upon my general experience with the game by customizing the controls to my liking. Now, fast forward to 2019, I now have an Elite controller for both of my Xbox consoles as well as my PC. So I was definitely interested to see what was coming when Microsoft announced the Series 2. Now that I finally got my hands on one of these, I am pumped to try it out and compare it to my original. Now, I did just get my hands on it. The box itself seems to carry the weight of a prestigious sounding Elite title, and at $150, I do expect more premium packaging as well. Alright, so on the front of the box, we have the Xbox logo, as well as a cool photograph of the controller and the Elite Series 2 nameplate, and the design is simple yet interesting. The top of the box carries the same simplicity as the design, with just minimal text and logos. So the left and right sides of the box both have a contents list, each list in different languages. The back of the box has four brief selling points on the controller, each listed in four different languages, which is a nice touch to the marketing for those who aren't in the US or whose first language is not English. Now, the bottom contains some basic information as well. The bottom contains copyright info in the UPC as well as the controller's serial number. Overall, the box is very simple but attractive in packaging, and gives the product a premium feel based off of its weight and material. As is typical with most electronics devices, the box is sealed by security tape. In this case, it has a specific spot that is designed to be rip away, so no sharp tools should be necessary to open the box, and then it will clearly show if the box has been opened. So let's go ahead and get this one opened up. We're gonna go ahead and just peel away the tearaway sections, and there's one on the top and the bottom of the box. We'll get those torn away and set aside. Now that we've got the security tape out of the way, let's go ahead and pull the box top off. And it is a little bit difficult to get started, but once you get it started, it falls away nicely and separates into two nice pieces here. So we'll set the top aside here so we can get into the contents of the box. Now, inside the box, the first thing you'll notice is that we have a similar clamshell case as the original Elite controller. And my unboxing of the Series 1 Gears of War Edition Elite Controller is linked below, as well as up on one of the title cards, so you can also check that out if you'd like. But for now, let's set aside the clamshell case and take a look at what's inside the box. And then we'll talk about what's inside the clamshell and its contents. So we'll go ahead and pull the insert out of the box. Down below is where we've got some of our other accessories. So first we have in this box the USB cable. And it's a USB-C cable that has a braided sleeve around the cable, giving it a more quality look than the standard rubberized cable. This cable is fairly long, and we can see, I would guess it's probably 10 to 15 feet long, which should be enough for most people to play while the cable is plugged in for charging if your batteries die. We'll go ahead and set that aside. And then we've got another little mini box in here. We'll go ahead and set the bottom aside since that's now empty. Now inside the second box here, inside of our main box is our manuals. It just opens up really nicely here. We'll just take a quick flip through the manual pages here because there isn't usually a ton to these. It's the manual and warranty guide. So it shows an accessory list for the controller, a picture of the controller, the back. It really just kind of gives us some nice information on the controller. So we'll go ahead and set that aside here. And then behind the Elite Series 2 manual, you have your product and regulatory guide with your warranty information. Nothing too interesting in there, so we're gonna toss that aside. And then also it looks like they give you a 14-day code for Xbox Game Pass Ultimate. So we will add 14 days onto my Game Pass. We'll pack up the brochures back into their box here and get that slipped back into the bottom. So now that we've looked at the contents that are inside the main box, let's go ahead and take a look at the clamshell case here. So I really do love these clamshell cases. They are quite beautiful. Let's go ahead and open it up and take a look at everything that's inside of it. So flip that open. And the first thing you've got, obviously, is your controller. So we'll pull out the controller. And I gotta say, this thing looks awesome. I am, like, super excited to get to use this. I really like the fit and finish of these Elite controllers. They are much nicer looking. The rubberized grips that wrap around the lobes on this thing, awesome to the touch, and I'm interested to see how they hold up and how they feel when actually gaming. So I really, really do like the feel of the new controller. The nice thing, the Series 2 controller does make some much needed updates to the original, adding an integrated battery pack, which does eliminate the need to swap and or buy rechargeable batteries. However, this does mean that in the event of battery exhaustion or failure, users may be unable to replace the battery themselves without voiding the warranty or disassembling the controller. So you can probably do that, but I haven't looked into seeing if you can buy batteries for the controller at this point. Also on the list of changes, the Series 2 is you've got the addition of the button allowing three profiles instead of two that were on a selector switch from the original Elite controller. So I do really like that you can change to another profile on the fly. It gives you a little bit more flexibility. The grips have also been changed on this guy, as I mentioned a moment ago, and the rubberized surface wraps around the entire lobe instead of just the bottom portions of the controller, which I do really like. The thumbsticks on the Series 2 now have an adjustable tension setting, which does allow a range of adjustment from the original 360 controller all the way up to the Elite controller, is the way Microsoft advertises it. And it can be adjusted by removing the cap from the controller and through there. And then guys, I will do a more in-depth review video talking about some of these options. So in addition to the thumbstick adjustment, they have added a third stop on the hair trigger adjustment. So you now have three different positions to allow for even shorter trigger pulls over the two position switch that was offered on the previous generation. So the first two positions feel like the standard options from the original Elite, and the third is definitely more precise. Here is the basic position. So you've got quite a decent amount of pull on that. Goes all the way down and inside. When we set it to position one, it reduces the pull by a decent amount. Well, have that there, and then when you reduce it to the other, it's even, or when you put it on the third setting, it's even further reduced. So I really like that. The precision hair trigger is one of my favorite things. It made for a lot nicer shooting experience in competitive first-person shooters. One of the biggest drawbacks on the previous generation of Elite controllers was the quality of the bumpers. Now, Microsoft does claim to have made the triggers and the bumper more durable for the Series 2, so we'll see that in our long-term review. But for now, let's go ahead and set aside the controller and take a look at what else comes in the accessory case. So at the top, inside the controller case, you have a netted area that you can use to secure your charging cable or other accessories. So we're gonna go ahead and we'll shove our charging cable in there. All right, so moving to the bottom portion of the case where the accessories are stored, we have a storage space for the two sets of paddles that can be removed and added to each individual user's preference. Also included in the Series 2 accessories are the adjustable thumbsticks. Now, on the controller come your short thumbsticks now instead of the medium thumbsticks. And the short and the medium thumbsticks both include the indented tops, and the face surface of the mediums is actually a little bit larger as well, not only in height but in face surface of the pad. Mine came with the short and smaller ones pre-installed on the controller. You also get one tall thumbstick, which I personally like to have on my right analog stick, gives me better aim. And then that one also has the indented style top. And then you get the outward sticking top, which is a medium height. Kind of interesting that that's the options, that you don't get a tall in it, that you don't get a tall in the outward or a extra short one. So that's what's included with the thumbsticks. My initial thoughts is I'm a little bit disappointed in the customizable options for the thumbsticks for people who may want them. However, as somebody who uses only one short and one tall, I have both of the thumbstick options that I would want to use, so I don't really need any additional ones. Now, Microsoft has also kept the same interchangeable D-pads, so you have the multi-point style D-pad as well as the traditional 4-point D. Now, I always run with the 4-point. I just don't see a need for the types of games I play to have the multi-point. So I'm gonna go ahead, and mine came with the multi-point pre-installed. I'm gonna go ahead and swap mine. Don't need any type of tool, so it's a simple operation as fold it up and off. It's magnetically attached. We'll put the multi-point one back into the case and swap it for our 4-point. And we'll just go ahead and let the magnets take care of that. And from there, you can see that they're not coming off. So we'll go ahead and get that installed. I'll also install my tall thumbstick on my right analog stick. And again, this is also an easy operation of literally just grabbing it by the top of the analog stick, giving it a gentle pull, and it comes straight off. We'll go ahead and set that one aside and replace it with our tall one, which again is just an easy operation as it's magnetically attached. And there we go. There is our customization to our controller in the way that I would use it. Added to the case is a charging dock that allows players to charge the battery in their controller without having it plugged into a cable. You can just rest it on top of here. It is magnetically attached to the case, so that's kind of cool. You can actually, we'll pull the velvet piece off there that protects it, can actually turn this thing upside down and not have the charging dock come out of there. And so we'll pull it, we'll detach it from the magnet, and the controller just sits on the charging dock and allows you to charge. The cool thing is, with it magnetically attached, you can run your cable through the back of the controller case out through a little rubber grommet, which is closable into the case, and have your controller charging while it's in your case, or you can take this out and connect it outside. And the thing I do like about the cable system on here, and they've kind of started to future-proof this, is now it is a USB Type-C on the charging cable, so we are no longer using the micro, mini, whatever it is, the mini or micro USB of the previous generations. So that's pretty slick. I do like that you can charge it in there, so you can keep it on your desk charging inside, and the controller case still does feel quite quality. And you can see here the spot where the rubber grommet comes in through the back, where you can plug it into the back of your charging dock. So overall, I think the fit and finish does seem to be improved on the controller over the original Elite, and I'm really excited to start using it. I've been wanting one of these since they announced it, so I'm pretty pumped about that. I'm going to be coming back to this controller in another video for a more in-depth review after I've had some time to use it and compare it to the Series 1 Elite controller. Once again, you can catch me live every Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and every other Wednesday at twitch.tv/powerwangz. Link, of course, right here. And if you like the video, make sure you smash that like button so that the YouTube algorithm knows that you liked it, and I know that you liked it. If you have any questions or things you would like to see me cover in the in-depth review video later on, make sure you leave those down in the comments below. I do try and respond to all of those in the first 24 hours. If you haven't already subscribed to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button as well as ring the notification bell. That way you get notified whenever we drop new content here. Guys, thanks for watching. Happy gaming.